I had a guy get a hold of me a while back about a G11, Ironco G11. Never have worked on one. Just received this in the mail today. I thought I'd purchase one and see if I can't, see what I can do with it. Basically, this is a butane gas. This is a butane lighter, but. Unfortunately, they don't make these anymore, and these canisters, especially on this particular model here, isn't refillable. They have some later on models. I guess they're later models that had a little refill valve in here. This one didn't, so I bought it, and I did. The only thing I've done to this is put a Flint in it, okay, just to see if. If it is sparking, you know, the Flint wheel isn't stuck or anything, and it seems to be okay there. All right. Anyway, hold on a minute here. I gotta get a notification here. My battery's low, so I'm gonna plug this charger in. So I should take care of it. It did. So what I'm going to do on this is see what I can figure out. Hopefully I don't burger this thing up, but just see what I can figure out on this here. Now apparently in order to adjust the flame height on this, you either turn this, you gotta have this closed, but apparently you can turn it clockwise or counterclockwise. Okay, and apparently you gotta adjust it with, it just spins and spins and spins. So apparently you gotta adjust the flame. This flame height adjuster is only usable when it's on, and it only gives me so much travel here. So let's just see what we got here. Okay. Let me zoom in here a little bit so you can see. See a little nub right there? Yeah, hold on here. Shaking a little bit here. See this one right here? This one's bent down compared to the other ones. So that there's your stop, okay, for your flame adjustment. Now, let's see, and that's right by the letter 66 here. It's right next to it under here. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to bend that up and see if I can't unscrew this whole assembly here, because just in case, I always like to service some, just see if I can get to any kind of an O-ring or just see how the mechanism works, because I'll be honest with you, I don't have a clue. It's unscrewing, so we got something going on here. Dirty mess. I don't know if that's a decomposed seal down there or what, but I gotta get my magnifiers on so I can look at something up close here. Let's take a peek at this here, see what we got. got a seal right here. Funky looking seal. Oh boy. This top part separates from this bottom part or not. I'm going to try to put just a little bit of let me get in here with my light and see what I can see on this. It actually looks like it's one piece. No, it pops out of there. Okay. Let's see what we can do here. Bear with me, I know I got this light kind of in the way here, but I'm trying to figure out something here, so just bear with me a minute. Figure out if this, once you get those little nubs, down through this top, if I can't rotate that to take that apart, I don't know. For a moment. All right. Okay, I'm thinking this is spring-loaded underneath for this little plunger here. Okay, put pressure on top of that little orifice on top there. So I just need to check out this seal, okay, and I need to check out the gas seal here, and we'll go from there. I'm going to have to get this up close so I can take a peek in here. Looks like that could be some, let's just see here. Yeah. Holy moly. Boy. Well, that's a mess down in there. Let me... Boy. Look at all that crap coming out there. What that is. But I don't see in that whole much butane. Looks like I can get that sealed back. Oh, that's a mess in there. Yep, just a second. All right, let's get a cotton swab and some alcohol. Go down in here and clean this out, see what we got. You know, that's got to be a sponge or something down in there that come out of there a big mess. I don't know. Okay. I'm gonna have to pause this video and empty this data card I got on here. I can see it's almost full already, so we'll do that right now. All right, All right, guys. I had to erase some data on my card, but in between time, I was trying to come up with a way to fix this lighter. You know, because I was going to, it wasn't something you just repair. I had to try to figure something out here. Now, I did put a filler valve in here. Okay. Now, what I used, I get these valves off of, I get them off of, I order them. I think, they're airsoft valves. Okay. The name of the joint is, they sent me some stickers here, so let me see what I can come up with. Oh yeah, here it is. The name of the joint is KWA. They're airsoft valves. Just get on their website, okay? Now, what you're going to need, though, you're going to have to drill a hole in the bottom of that. I didn't sand none of that emblems down or anything. It's on that because I used a pretty stiff O-ring, so it doesn't leak. I've checked it. What you want to do is drill a small pilot hole. Then you want to slowly go up to where... Use a 4.2 millimeter size drill bit. I got these off of eBay. All right. Then, once you get the hole drilled, you want to use a... Let's see if I can zoom in here on this. It's a 4 point, it's M4.5 by 5 tap, okay, 4.5 millimeter by 0.5 pitch. All right, now it goes in, it screws in a little bit, then it gets kind of hard. So I put your O-ring on it, and I put a little bit of O-ring grease around the threads on that, and just cinch it down. All right. Don't go real hard, because you don't want to take a chance of cracking that plastic. That plastic is pretty thick in there. I don't know how thick it is. It's pretty thick, but still, you want to take a chance of cracking it, splitting it. So. Tap it out, run it all, tap all the way down in there, and kind of run it out, run it in a little bit, and in and out, and back it in, you know, tap it in, tap it out, but then put your valve in there. Now, I got this going. Let me zoom out and shut my light off here. But it's not perfect yet, okay? And I want to show you why it's not perfect and so far, but all right. Now, you seen earlier, I had to bend that little tab back on that so I can unscrew this out. There's some butane in there, so you know what? Just let me unscrew this and blow maybe. I don't know how much gas is in this. Well, let me put a little in here to blow the insides out. Okay, there we go. There's the insides. Now, earlier, I showed you, I took this little, you remember, right? I took this apart. There's a bunch of gunk seal in there on top of this. Okay, if you remember right. And I pulled that out, and this had a little bit of rubber piece or something around here. It had three little nubs on it. I think that was the three little nubs that was sitting on the shelf of this right in here. And there was a pressure washer between. Okay, well, I had to clean all that out, you know, so make sure this orifice wasn't plugged up. As you can see, it's open. But, you know, I got thinking, what am I going to do, you know? So, I had to just, luckily I had some lighter parts. And what I did is I just broke, first thing I did is I got a sponge out of a disposable lighter, okay? Then I had this sitting around in my parts. Let me zoom up on this. So you can be able to see this. This is just a little brass piece that I use. But see how it's got a slot in between it right there? And you know what? Let me get my... You can see I almost got a slot in there. All right. Flat on one side. The reason it's got the slot in there is to let gas just pass through, because what I end up doing is using this. This is approximately 4 millimeters in diameter and approximately 1.14 millimeters thick. Okay, now if you want to find a little bitty piece of brass or something, you can get it to work. Just get your little file a slot in it. You say, well, what's the slot for? Well, the slot's for is for this here, because this here part is going to be stuck in the bottom here, and you want the slots down. What the slots does, you know, you can actually probably make that a little bit thicker. Okay, actually, you can probably get by with 5 millimeter diameter, just so it sticks down in there. What the slot does allows gas to come up through butane out the side of this round washer here. Okay. And what I did is I just put a pressure washer down on top of that. All right, now I cleaned this up, this little part here that I got out. Okay, I cleaned it up pretty well. Now, I used this, just a second here. I used this smaller O-ring to go around this, because when I push this part down inside, when I put this part, now let me zoom out a little bit. When I put this part down in here like this, it actually, it's got to have an O-ring around it so it seals the gases off. So the gases only come through this little orifice hole here. All right, so I'm still, and I got to figure out the O-ring. Let's see here. Let me figure out the O-ring that I used on that. Just a minute here. This is the O-ring I used on the filler valve. All right. These are FKM O-rings. These are high temp O-rings, and not only that, but they're about 85 durals, so they work good on like replacing filler valves and stuff like that, where you want to tighten them, cinch them down a little bit, because Benzies are a little stiffer, you know, they stand the pressure. They won't deform as you put a little pressure on them. I gotta try to find an O-ring that fits better around that, because the one I had on there, to be honest with you, it just isn't cutting it. And I don't know what to use. I'm gonna try to figure something out here. Here's a 4.1. This is a Boone 90. But I don't know if that's I think that's just a little too big. I really do. I think that's just a little too big. I don't know. That might do her. Okay, keep that in mind if I put that together and that works. 4x1. Alright. Actually, what that means is 4 millimeter inner diameter, 1 millimeter cord size. So it's a 6 millimeter total outer diameter. Alright. So let me put this together. Okay, let's put this back together here. You know, the only thing I can get better than this is something that's actually just 5 millimeter in diameter. But this is all I had, so I'm going to use it for now. Put that thing in there, I don't know how many times, and there we go. Just wanting to center it over that hole a little bit. Put that in there. Now I'm gonna push that down in there. I'll tell you what it did too. If you look on earlier, if you back it up, okay, and you look, if you remember right, it had a little bit of indentation in it, okay. So what I did, got a little pick out of here, picked it out of there, and just put it in upside down. So this is new, and this is still pliable. This is a good seat here. But if you ever have to get to the point where you have to replace that seat, you're gonna have to get a little razor blade and cut them little just the way this is, because what's that doing right there is once this valve opens, pulling it up like that, okay, your gas is coming around the little crevices around that seat and going up and right out here. This don't need to be taken apart. I figured this out. This is kind of a spring-loaded deal. Once I took the stopper out here, you can see a hole all the way through. So when you open your lighter up, it just basically takes this thing and lifts this part, top part of it up. Lets gas through. So just keep that in mind. I'm going to put this on here like so, and I'm going to see if I can't. That O-ring, I might have to put a little bit of... Boy, that O-ring's stiff too. That's a Dural 90. Whew. You know, I need to try to find a Dural 70 on that, because them 90s are tough. They don't give. They don't give that well at all. Trouble is, I don't think I have a a Dural 90 in that size, or a Dural 70 in that size. No, I don't. Well, let me go to my oddball O-ring size right here. I'm going to go ahead and leave that off, Dural 90 right there, and I'm going to get in here and see if I can find something that'll a little softer that'll work. That could possibly work right there. Just have to spread a little bit. I can tell it's a little softer. Put my magnifiers on, put this on with my fingers. That seems to be working good. I don't know, that could be another 90 got mixed in the batch here. But if so, well, let's try it with something else. All right. Let's go ahead and put this back together here. One more time. I think it's a 5mm. Be a little bit better on that. All right. I'm gonna, with one hand here, try to put a little O-ring grease around there. That might go down and screw in better. Possibly. To use something a little bit smaller, folks. Let me try another. See, that's the deal on these. You just got to find something that works. These O-rings, everybody, it's just not a, you know, I put these lighters together and it works. You know, everything seems easy on video, but, well, it's not always as it seems. Now let me get something a little bit bigger here, maybe. That might be the same thing, but yeah, that's something that's a little thicker. Well, the calendar's a a little thicker there, so we'll go with this one. Got that clock in here. I guess you guys can probably hear that ticking. Definitely gonna have to take that out of the next video. All right, I got it screwed in. We might, let's see what we get. All right, let's see what we get here. Butane in it. All right, nothing out, so we'll loosen up a little bit right here on this. Should have something, but now there we go. Got a small flame. Shut the light off here and I'll turn that a little bit. There we go. Get a little hot there, folks. Boy. I'm going to top this off. You see the butane in there? That's pretty full. See what happens when I top it off. All right. Yeah, I got a leak around the seal, I think. Let me see. Leak around that seal. Maybe. Tell you what, that's probably about as good as you're gonna get on that. But let's zoom out on that. All right, let's turn her down. Got a flame down. Now flame high. Well, that's plenty high, folks. See, I didn't bend that tab back out to limit the flame height on that. I think I'd limit my flame height on that about 2 inches maximum. You can't light something with 2-inch flame, and you better go get a torch. When I shut this, it should come. Yeah, see how the gas is turned off. Gas is off now. Turn it, I won't strike it, but say now it's on. All Yeah, that's when it comes to your Imco, this G11, this is probably about as good as far as rebuilding, because I'm gonna probably fine tune a little bit if I can find a bigger round size diameter in that brass. I've got a brass tube that's 5 millimeters OD, and I just might go ahead and just solder a, solder, put some solder into it, cut it off, solder it, and put a little channel in it or something. But I just don't want stuff in there turning around, I want everything in there solid so that sponge doesn't move and cause any kind of difficulty. But seems to be working well. All right, guy out there wanted me to work on one of his butane canisters, and he tried to send it to me, but I thought he's from the States, but I guess he is somewhere in Turkey or something. But anyway, guy, I'll try to send you a link if I can. Hopefully you're watching this. The best thing you can do is just do what I told you in the video, Get some, when you're putting an O-ring on these valves, I'll get you a hard one like a 90 or, an FKM O-ring, FKM type. They're about 85 Duro, so they're an excellent quality. This is where I get my O-rings. O-rings and more here in the States. I don't know what you're going to do. And, if you're out of the country, you're just going to have to try to find a source your own. But hopefully, guys, this has helped somebody out there. It's got a nice Imco G11 that they want to restore, and I hope this helps you out, gives you a little bit of help some way, one way or another.